Hello students, this is Professor Nilesh Kale, and in this video we are learning about GST registration section 23. So section 23 says persons not liable for GST registration. What the section 23.A says, clause A, any person engaged exclusively in the business of supplying goods or services or both that are not liable to tax or wholly exempt from tax under this act or under IGST Act. An agriculturist to the extent of supply of produce out of cultivation of the land. So this is given in section 23. An agriculturist to the extent of produce, such produce which is out of the cultivation of land is considered as GST exempt. And any such person who is exclusively in the business of supplying goods or both but is not liable to tax wholly or partly, we are speaking only about wholly, okay. Even if you are liable to tax partly, you will have to take registration under GST and pay the GST. The government may, on the recommendation of the council, by notification specify the category of persons who may be exempted from obtaining registration. Now, notification, as we have learnt in the previous class, notification number 10, which was already issued, that says you will have to keep away from the GST. Now, clause 1 says supplier making exempt supplies and the agriculturist. So if you are making any exempt supplies, then you need not take registration, then you are not liable for registration. And an agriculturist, individual or HUF involved in land cultivation only. If any such agriculturist is doing any other work, then that person is liable for registration again. Right? So subsection 2 says any other such person as notified. So it is already notified, that says supplier in RCM as recipient is paying GST, supplier need not get registered. This is common sense. So supplier in RCM will be falling under this point, section 23 subsection 2, right? So the turnover based exemption is given to certain supplies falling under section 24. So section 24 is for compulsory registration, but turnover based exemption is given to some suppliers. So let us see the chart over here. Turnover based applicability is given. So an agent whose principal is registered. So please understand, if there is an agent whose principal is registered, then for goods not available, for services not available, it means see, section 23 subsection 2 is not available, it means they have to take the registration. Why? Because section 23 says persons not liable for registration. If two no's are there, then the answer is yes. OIDAR services supplier, then, or NRTP, that is non-resident taxable person making overseas supplier, still there is not applicable. Now, what is this not applicable? Please understand, exemptions from registration to certain suppliers through notification. So we are speaking about notification. Which notification? Just now we have spoken about. See, this turnover based exemption is available. Let me go to the previous slide here. Turnover based exemption is given under the notification, right? So this notification says yes, you do not have turnover based exemption. NRTP, non-resident taxable persons, themselves have no turnover based exemption. Now what about casual taxable persons, CTP? Aggregate turnover will be 20 or 10 lakhs. Yes, for handicrafts and craftsmen. So if you are supplying such goods which are made by handicrafts or craftsmen, then yes, turnover based exemption is available for you, but for services not applicable. So interstate supplier, if you are interstate supplier, you are falling under section 24, that is compulsory registration, but still you have aggregate turnover basis. I am to say you will have turnover applicability is 20 or 10 lakhs, yes, for handicrafts and craftsmen, and for all other services you have exemption from registration based on the turnover. So interstate supplier, what do you understand here? I will tell you one small point. Friends, you are making an interstate supply. Section 24 says, see, Section 24 says, if you are making an interstate supply, you have to take compulsory registration. Look at this point, compulsory GST registration in certain cases. In these many cases, you have to take compulsory registration. Look at this point, interstate taxable supply. So if you are making interstate taxable supply, you will have to take registration. But Section 23 subsection 2 says, yes, you are an interstate supplier, but your aggregate turnover is less than 20 lakh in case of goods and less than 10 lakh in case of services, then yes, you have the turnover applicable. I am to say, you need not get registration because your aggregate turnover is less than the threshold limit. So this exemption is applicable, right? So supplier to ECO, that is electronic commerce operator, who is collecting TCS, tax collected at source, then aggregate turnover is also applicable to them, but for all the services and not for the goods. Because e-commerce operator is a service provider, not goods provider, and therefore for all services turnover based limit is given to them. Please note, to give the benefit to the supplier under section 24, this section is used. To whom we are giving this benefit? We are giving benefit to the supplier under section 24. So this section is used to give them relaxation for exemption from the registration based on the turnover, right? So let us go for section 24, that is compulsory GST registration in certain cases. What is that? Individuals registered under pre-GST law. What is this pre-GST law? Be that excise, VAT, VAT is value added tax, or the service tax, etc. Any other pre-GST law, if you were registered earlier, then you have to compulsorily get registration in the GST. The first, very first point. By now, this is already 2020, the GST Act has been introduced in section 2 in the year 2017, and therefore many almost everybody might have already transferred themselves from earlier laws to the GST. So that transition might have been happened. So the first point stands void. Second point, businesses with turnover above the threshold limit. So if your threshold limit is more than, if your turnover is more than the threshold limit, what is threshold limit? 20 or 20 lakh or 10 lakh or 20 lakh or 40 lakh, whatever is the case, maybe as we have learned in the previous videos, or you can also go through the aggregate turnover chapter, where the link is given in the description box. Please understand, if your turnover is more than threshold limit, you have to compulsorily get registered, which is also a part of section 22, right? So the persons making any interstate taxable supply, this point I have spoken just now, if you are making interstate taxable supply, then yes, you have to take GST registration. Casual taxable persons making taxable supply. Casual taxable person, that is CTP, making taxable supply, for them also. So I will go to the previous slide. Casual taxable persons making taxable supply, yes, there is aggregate turnover based exemption available, right? Next point, persons who are required to pay tax under reverse charge. So for reverse, and if you are paying taxes under reverse charge, you will have to take registration because it is compulsory registration. And then persons who supplies via e-commerce aggregator, again I will go to the previous point. See, for e-commerce operator, this relaxation is available, right? So every e-commerce operator who is required to collect tax at source, TCS, this amendment is done under the GST Amendment Act 2018, that is what I have added in this previous slide. Then persons supplying online information. Persons supplying online information and database access or retrieval services from a place outside India to a person in India, then you have to compulsorily get registered in GST. Agents of a supplier and input service distributor have to get GST registration, right? So compulsory registration goes something like this. An agent whose principal is registered, yes, you have to get registered. You'll have to get registered in the GST. Wide air services, NRTP and CTP, and interstate supplier and supplier to ECO. All these points have been added in the previous slide here in this chart. So turnover based relaxation from registration is given, even if it is given in section 24. Hope you have understood, right? So other than the principal supplier, recipient making RCM have to take the registration, registered as tax deductor, they have to take the registration, ECOs, e-commerce operators considered as a deemed supplier and collecting TCS as per section 9 and subsection 5. This is for the reverse charge mechanism, that is the reverse charge section 9, section subsection 5, and ISD, that is input service distributor. Even if you are an input service distributor, you will have to take registration under the GST or any other which is not mentioned as of November 2020. I am recording this video in the month of December 2020, but that is fine. As of December 2020, any others, this point is there in section 24, but nothing is mentioned here, right? So this is all about section 24. Please note that every person who is liable to be registered under section 22 or section 24 shall apply for registration within each state or union territory in which he is also liable within 30 days from the date on which he becomes liable to registration. Please understand, they have to apply for registration within 30 days from the date of liability to get registered, right? So in case of casual taxable person, CTP or NRTP, non-resident taxable person, shall apply for registration at least 5 days prior to the commencement of the business. And in case of any other person who makes supply from the territorial waters of India shall obtain registration in the coastal state or union territory where the nearest point of appropriate business line, baseline is located. What is this baseline and all? I have already spoken about this in the previous videos. Please go through all those videos. Subscribe to this channel, Nilesh Kale, where you will get all the videos, right? So this is all about section 23 and section 24. Hope this is all understood. If you have any points or clarifications to be done, please comment below this video, and see you in next video. Thank you.